G'day mates, welcome back to my YouTube channel. In today's video, I'm going to be covering everything that happened in the last 24 hours of tournaments, and there was so much that went down. We had Taysons' team win the EU Trio Cash Cup in such dominant fashion. They were set to be the first team to ever win the EU and NAE's Trio Cash Cups back-to-back until they got so ridiculously unlucky. I'm going to talk about exactly what happened to them later in the video. We also had Letshe make waves with his new team, Seven Josh and Bobby. He placed in the EU Trio Cash Cup, was so excited to finally be placing with a new team again before his teammate Bobby got banned. A lot of people are saying this is for macros. Letshe came out and said that it wasn't for macros, so I want to cover exactly what happened there, what we know, and what's just rumor. We also had the SypherPK Trials tournament today as well, which was absolutely dominated by Bucky, Macwood, and Unknown Army. Bucky fans rose, he popped off. It was such a good tournament, but that's not it. We also have DreamHack coming back, and I'm not talking DreamHack Cash Cup Extra like I've already talked about. I'm talking about potentially $250,000 of prize pools a month for DreamHack duos that anyone can play in. This isn't a Cash Cup Extra. This is its own separate tournament like DreamHack that we know and love. So qualifiers, semifinals, and set finals. I'm so excited. I want to cover all those details at the end of today's video, how you qualify, what the format is, what the prize pool's like, and anything you'd want to know. Also, guys, just quickly, I will be doing a video talking about the update if there's enough to make a video on. I filmed these videos earlier in the day. I've been up since 4 a.m. to watch the SypherPK Cup, but don't worry. If the update's a banger, I'll make a video tomorrow. I got you. If you guys are loving the daily uploads and you want to support me, please use code Aussie in the Fortnite item shop and click that big red subscribe button down below. Thank you so much. Kicking things off with the Trio Cash Cups, I want to go in chronological order, so we'll kick off with OCE first. Now, OCE's Cash Cup was pretty exciting. The games were surprisingly stacked, and I think this is due to not a lot of people in OCE being Champions Division yet because the queue times have been so terrible. So it really was the best of the best, but we already kicked it off with a really big upset. I talked about how X2 Twins are coming back into competitive Fortnite, and they're doing it with none other than Fresh and Rel's old teammate Nubatoon. Well, how do you think they went? They placed. They did so insanely well. They came sixth place, getting 197 points. They were only 8 points behind the FNCS champions, Jinx, Alec, and Worthy. They did so insanely well, but not only that, they massively outplaced Fresh's team. Nubatoon obviously probably felt good about that one. Fresh and Rel playing with their new teammate Oatly for the first time in a tournament came 39th, only getting 128 points. So that's almost 70 points less than the Twins coming out of retirement playing with Nubatoon. So it looks like, I think Nubatoon is definitely staying with Twins, whether Fresh's team gave him an option or not. People are asking me out without the whole night, is Oatly that much worse than Nubatoon? Oatly's terrible, and I saw Oatly getting a lot of the flame. I just genuinely think Fresh and Rel didn't play their best either. It was just some wrong decisions, and I don't think having Nubatoon over Oatly would have helped that a lot. It was just stuck in bad positions, stuck in bad situations, just losing fights they shouldn't have lost. I don't really think it was an Oatly versus Nubatoon thing, and I don't think Fresh Rel are going to struggle with Oatly many times. I think it was just a once-off poor tournament, but I don't want to take away from how insanely well the X2 Twins and Nubatoon performed. I mean, it doesn't look like the Twins took a break at all. If anything, from watching Jesse play, Jesse looks better than what he was before he took his break, and Nubatoon looks like he's focused up, he's not tilting, and his mental was in check because they absolutely popped off. Moving on to EU, we have one of the most dominant performances we've ever seen in a Cash Cup, not just EU. We had 4ZR, Taysen, and Nate, the newly formed team, take it all, getting first place on 236 points, 33 points above second place. Actually ridiculous. And look at their match history. They had 8 matches played with 5 wins. 8 matches played with 5 wins on EU with 12.38 average eliminations and an average placement of 6.75. Let's just look at their match history. 34 elimination win, 11 elimination win, 15 elim win, 13 elim win, 4 wins back to back. Then they got a 1 elim 25th, but that's only 4 minutes of wasted time. That's a throwaway. That's fine. 13 elim win, then a 7 elim 6th place, and unluckily their last game, their worst game of the day was a 5-elim 18th place, which took 20 minutes. If it wasn't for that, they were just going to even break 250 points. But still, even with that game, they were so insanely dominant. They absolutely popped off, showing they are one of the best new teams, not just in EU, but in the world. As they then took to NA East, after three games, they were actually in the lead on NA East. They had a 3-point lead, and then they started to run into what already happened to 4ZR and Nate during the last FNCS, French internet problems. Now, I don't understand what this is. Apparently, the internet service provider is called Orange. Apparently, they're known for having these issues, and not only did it affect them, it also affected Clement's team that was in fourth place as well. Luckily, though, for Taysons' team, they actually have two internet service providers now. I believe it's Nate or 4ZR. I think it might be Nate, who now has to have two internet service providers, so if Orange has issues, he can swap over to the other. So I don't think it caused them too many issues in the end. They said they could have won the whole thing if they got a bit of extra zone luck as well. It's good to see that they're prepared for these issues, but I mean, two internet service providers, because it's likely that one of them will just not let you play Fortnite at all. Not like it goes down and you can't access anything. For some reason, it just causes issues with connecting to Fortnite. But unluckily for a lot of the EU pros, some people just don't have an option. Sometimes Orange is their only option. So you had another EU team, like I said, Clement, that was actually in top four, looking like they could win the Cash Cup as well. And I don't think they were actually able to play much of the rest of the tournament. They dropped right down the leaderboards. Now, let's get to the bottom of exactly what's going on with Letshe's new teammate, Bobby, and why he's been banned and what this means for Letshe. So if you don't know, Letshe has finally found a new team that he was performing really, really well with. They actually managed to come top 20 today in the EU Trio Cash Cup. They were halfway through the NA East Cash Cup before Bobby got kicked from the game three times, and then he ended up getting banned. Now, this is where things get a little bit weird. Everyone's trying to figure out exactly what's going on. Letshe was trying to figure out. Bobby was trying to figure out. There's been a whole bunch of deleted tweets, and there's a whole bunch of accusations going around. You guys know me. I absolutely hate witch hunting. I don't like just going out and presenting it. I want to wait until Epic hopefully makes a statement, or whether we actually get a statement at all. But it looks like the information we did have presented was Bobby believes that he was banned because he was getting hacked, because that's why he got logged out three times, which is a little bit weird, because normally when you get banned for cheating or banned for something else, you just get logged out or you get kicked out and you're banned. You don't get logged out three times to be allowed to log back in to then get banned. But at the same time, a whole bunch of people started throwing around accusations of macros. His teammate even tweeted something out mentioning something about that he got banned for macros and then since deleted those tweets. We had Letshe tweet out that he wasn't banned for macroing and he would make a longer defense later tonight, and he'd make a tweet about exactly what's going on. But it looks like even Letshe had a change of heart. He ended up pretty much just tweeting out a bunch of tweets about how things aren't looking good. This doesn't look good for me right now. I can't lie. Not going to tweet anything for the rest of the tonight. I'm going to listen now to depression music and cry in bed. Good night. I mean, like, Letshe's not feeling good about it. I don't know if that means Letshe and 7Josh both knew something. Bobby since deleted his tweet about why he thinks he didn't get banned for any real reason. He ended up pretty much just tweeting, "I actually can't sleep. I'm just too frustrated." So I don't know if there's going to be a situation where we have to wait around for Epic to make a statement. There was other pros talking about how Bobby has clips of him using crouch macros, which is just a way to crouch up and down really quickly. But again, I don't like witch hunting. I don't like going back through clips and doing stuff like that, because I just want to wait for Epic Games to hopefully make a statement, or Bobby to make a statement, and not just witch hunt someone based off random clips and deleted tweets. This could potentially mean that Letshe is yet again without a team. We are pretty much less than 2 weeks out from FNCS. He finally found a team after saying he was probably going to quit the game. They were working fantastically, and it might all be over. If Bobby stays banned, Letshe needs a new team. And based on the tweets that I saw from their third mate, 7Josh, I don't know if they're going to stay together with Letshe and find a third. But man, at this point, I'm just feeling so bad for Letshe. Seriously, this guy cannot catch a break. Before we move on to NA East, though, I do want to talk about some other big talking points out of EU. We had some insane performances from Snag's team, Nikoff's team staying together since last FNCS, still looking so dominant in third place. We have Scram's new team coming in fourth place. And I mean, when you compare that to how his old team went, RefsGuard and Andretto, who's now obviously picked up Mr. Savage, who came 313th, probably one of the biggest disappointments from the tournament. I'm not 100% sure exactly what happened here. Mr. Savage Savage right now, looking like one of the best solo players in the world, but unfortunately his new trio not really putting it together. But there were some other big teams that didn't perform either. I mean, you had Thomas HD, Flick, and Anas come in 325th, but you had the new team, Mongrel Mitro Milan, the one that had so many eyes on it, came 1,243rd. So don't really know what happened there. They only got three top 12s in the whole tournament, which is not really great for this trio. If Mongrel and Mitro want to be the best again, they need to start scrimming again. I feel like that's what this shows. They have the potential, but I just don't think they're taking it as seriously right now. Still, Pumps are back in the game. They have the ability to dominate again. A lot of people have talked about, you know, they need a lot of mobility. They play too hyper-aggressive. They're going to need an older, more calm IGL like Rojo, maybe something like Aqua. I don't know what's going on there. I don't want to jump to any major conclusions, but our first showing of Mongrel, Mitro, and Milan together was unfortunately not the best. The other big name team I know you're going to ask about, Benjyfishy, Matso, and Umplify. They came in 32nd, so not too bad. It wasn't fantastic for them, but they did still get prize money. They also managed to qualify for DreamHack Extra. Remember, this tournament is going into DreamHack Cash Cup Extra. The top 132 teams that qualified from this Cash Cup go straight into that. It's going to take place in a few days, so that's super exciting, and that's a bit of extra cash or a bit of a chance for these guys to go into as well. We had Scoped, Tragics, and Decent NA team show up on EU as well. They will also be playing in the Cash Cup Extra. They came 34th. We saw Vidil, Noah, and Rezon. They came in 67th. So not an insane performance by them. Obviously, they are a more aggressive team. They're known to do really well in these Cash Cups. They're still piecing it all together, though. I don't think they've been practicing as much at the start of the season. We haven't really seen them play any of the third-party tournaments. Chapix, Hen, and Janice, our former FNCS champs, though, look like they're back together. They did play. They came 70th overall, so nothing insane. Not really the performance to put them back on the map and show that they are here to stay, but they are playing together. Moving on to NA East, we had Slax, Jack, and Acorn, our FNCS champions, win yet again another tournament. This trio is ridiculous. They are genuinely winning everything right now. They didn't do it in as dominant performance as Taysons' team on EU, but they played insanely well. They finished on 198 points with 8 matches played, 1 victory L, an average of limbs of 11.25, and an average placement of 6.88. It was a phenomenal performance for them. They did fall short a few times. They got a 6th, a 4th, a 2nd, and a 2nd, and 8th. So, I mean, with a few extra moves, that's like one layer wrong. That's one extra flopper, one extra shot, and you're getting massive, massive points. So, they really did play insane. I think their points didn't justify just how well they actually did. They just beat out, and now don't panic. This isn't a newly formed team. We had DGen, Skittles, and Khanada. Now, obviously, Kanada's not allowed to play in the Twitch Rivals tournaments. I've talked about this in the past. Khanada is still permanently banned on Twitch. If you want to know why, I'll put a link to a video in the description down below that fully explains it. But in short, Khanada has been permanently banned on Twitch for supposedly bullying another streamer or another player during a wager, making IRL threats like, I'm going to come to your house. Obviously, I think most people know Khanada wasn't going to go to this kid's house, but Twitch wanted to make kind of a statement, I guess, of him, and they're sticking through to that. Not only is he still banned on Twitch, he's not allowed to play in Twitch tournaments, so that is why Bucky and Macwood played with Unknown Army and ended up winning the SypherPK Twitch Rivals Cup, but I'll get into that a little bit later. That's why if you see any other weird teams as well, I know Bizza was playing with Ved, Booger sat the tournament out, Clix wasn't able to play in it. There was a lot of weird teams going around because there was some mismatched teams for Twitch Rivals, and because that overlapped into the Cash Cup, a lot of them found new teams as well. But overall, it was a really solid performance. Some other big notable teams like Daymir and Reverse coming in 6th place. You had Mega and Dubs up there. They were actually winning for a good majority of the tournament. They ended up dropping down into 5th place with their new teammate Illest, but an insane performance from them, showing that maybe Mega and Dubs are back in a big way. All they needed was that extra firepower from Illest. I obviously already talked about it, but we saw that we had Taysons' team in 10th place, but we managed to have another EU team in 8th. Not a permanent team, but we had Bloomy, I believe Percival, and Rezon come in 8th place overall. EU really did show up. We had Flick, Anas, and Thomas HD, after playing terribly on EU, came 14th on NA. We also had Queasy, Trulex, and Jerky. They came in 17th place for EU as well, so an insane performance for them. Remember, this NAE's Cash Cup was a bit harder to judge. You had a lot of the guys from NRG still in LA, and you had a lot of the players who would have played have to start late because of Twitch Rivals. Before we talk about exactly what's going on with DreamHack, we are going to talk about SypherPK's Twitch Rival Tournament. It was insane. It was 7 rounds of just ridiculous game modes. The tournament started with the rule set being whichever team dies last, whoever gets the victory owl loses 5 points. So just, it already set the tone for what was going to be a ridiculous tournament. Everyone landed on the lighthouse because it was right under the bus, jumped off. It was actually Bucky, Macwood, and Unknown Army who lost this one. They started the tournament with a -5 deduction, but as the tournament went on, they absolutely dominated. There was a few game modes in there. I think there was bows only and throwables only. There was a makeshift only. There was a pickaxe only. There was a whole bunch of fun game modes in there, but overall, there was no real drama. Surprisingly, normally with tournament rule sets like this, usually a bunch of people make mistakes. There's always a bunch of issues. The only real one was when Punisher's team playing with Nick A30 used a primal AR instead of using only makeshift weapons to take down SypherPK's own brother, Junior. He was incredibly apologetic. Junior was pretty fired up. He was pretty upset. He definitely was going in on Punisher on stream, but Punisher manned up. He felt terrible. He apologized. He ended up backing out of the game. Nick A30 and their teammate were able to play on, but in the confusion, they ended up getting wiped out by Bucky's team anyway. And this was after Nick A30 crashed in the 2 rounds before it. So it was 4 rounds in, and the only game mode that Nick A30 got to play was trying to make himself die first. It was unfortunate, but overall for everyone else, the tournament was so much fun. I really enjoyed it. The servers held up surprisingly well, even in like the bow challenges, which were super, super stacked. It was really, really fun. And honestly, SypherPK killed it commentating. It was Sancho. And it just made me realize how much room there are for these fun tournaments. The Amar Cup, which if you haven't watched any of the content on it, go watch Benjyfishy's video where he plays with his mum and CRR. It is genuinely some of the best content I've ever seen. This tournament was so much fun. The pros were getting involved. The content creators were getting involved. I mean, it did end up getting cleaned out by the pros anyway, but a lot of the content creators had a lot of fun and they had a really, really good showing. I mean, you did have Macwood, Bucky, and Unknown Army come out in first. You had Emad GG, Centered and Commandment come out. Sorry, Centered and yeah, Commandment come in second. Edgy wasn't able to play, so the pros were up there. But look at this leaderboard. Macwood's team got 125 points. Second place was 58. They absolutely popped off. They got 220 elimination victory royales. And I know what you're gonna think. Oh, they were hard sweating, pro sweating in a content creator tournament. For the most part, like, I mean, they were taking it semi-seriously, but they're also having a laugh. There was a number of times where Bucky was just being Bucky. I mean, Bucky's streams at the moment are an entirely different vibe altogether. They won the tournament and they had so much fun and they went on to play the Cash Cup afterwards. I'm really happy that no pro tried to dip out of the tournament at the end. It did mean they started a little bit late for the Cash Cup, but I wanted to cover the tournament because it was just so much fun. If you want to watch any of the highlights of the SypherPK Cup, we're going to be putting up a highlight video on my second channel. It's Extra Antics. I'll put a link in the description down below. Check it out. That video is going to go live a few hours after this video. Make sure you check it out. It's a good laugh. It was all the best parts from the viewing party I did today, which was genuinely one of the most fun I've done in such a long time. Now, to finish it off with a big juicy one, DreamHack is back. We have up to $250,000 in prize pool each month for Duo DreamHack. I don't know how many months this is going to run for. Maybe it's just for April. The information's a little bit sparse when it comes to certain parts. The reason why I say up to that prize pool is because if you go to the website where you register, where you sign up, it says, what's up April? From June 2020, we hosted open participation online Fortnite competitions with a monthly prize pool of $250,000 up for grabs. Fans throughout EU and NA were able to participate, and we hit a new record of 1 million signups in January 2021. After a short break, we're thrilled to be back with an April edition. We will be providing official coverage broadcasted live on Twitch with professional commentary and in-game observing. I mean, you guys are just going to come watch it on my Twitch anyway, right? I'm going to be doing a viewing party. It's going to be fantastic, but it doesn't mention a prize pool. We don't actually know how much money is for, so I'm assuming it's going to be the same $250,000 prize pool because that's what it looks like if you read the whole sentence properly. But also, there's no NA West. It's only taking place for EU and NA East. It isn't region locked though, so you can play in it from outside those regions. You just have to sign up. If you want to sign up or get any information I don't cover here in today's video, again, link will be in the description down below. It's going to be taking place on April 16th to April 18th. Like I already said, it is duos. It is an open qualifiers with 500 duos advancing from each heat heat to the semi-finals. There's going to be two heats, the semi-finals and the grand finals. That is for Europe. For NA East, though, there is only one heat, semi-finals, and grand finals. Now, the scoring format looks fantastic. It says during the qualifying heats, eliminations give 4 points. During semi-finals and finals, eliminations give 6 points. So eliminations being worth a little bit more in those final rounds, which mirrors what our Epic's trying to do with the FNCS. But we have our usual incredibly stacked placement heavy format from DreamHack. We have 25th. I think you start getting 2 points at 25th, and you're going to get 2 placement points for every placement until 5th. Once you hit 5th, though, you're going to get 40 points. This is total. Then at 4th, you're going to get 3 extra points. 3rd, you'll get 3 extra points. 2nd, you're going to get 3 extra points. And the Victory Royale nets you 6 extra points overall. So you're going to get 55 points. Points for first place, but when you think the fact that eliminations are worth 4, it's not that placement heavy overall, but it's incredibly consistent placements, and that's what people really like from DreamHack. When it comes to the finals, though, eliminations being worth 6 and first only being 55 points, I mean, it's less than 10 eliminations for the Victory Royale, but again, it'll be set lobbies. It's going to be stacked. I really, really liked DreamHack's format in the past, despite it rewarding eliminations so heavily, because placement is so consistent. It really does reward the teams that stay alive the whole way through and consistently get that like top 5 and a few eliminations. The opens round might be a little bit W key, but I mean, we've got a grand finals that's going to be 8 set lobby games. I'm so, so excited. And they said new games start every 35 minutes. Thank you, DreamHack. If you ever watched my viewing parties, you know how triggered I got. Every DreamHack finals would have, the set lobby finals would have 15 minute breaks between games. So if you died on spawn in one game, it was like 45 minutes till another. 35 minutes looks like it's gonna be more around the 10 minute mark, maybe even a little bit less. So that's not, it's getting closer to like the 5 minutes that I think it should be. But overall, if you have any more questions, any more confusions, check out their website. They've got frequently asked questions. If you wanna sign up, you just go there, click on the link, sign up. It's super, super easy. It'll be through the compete tab in Fortnite like it was last time. All right, guys, that does it for another video. I know it was a long one. There was so much to cover. I know you guys say you always love the longer videos, so I know it's not an issue. If you enjoyed it, if you made it this far, you're a real one. Please chuck a like on it. Let me know in the comment section down below your thoughts on anything that happened today. I know it was a crazy one. If you haven't already, please subscribe to the channel. It would mean the world to me. Thank you so much for watching. And I'll see you in the next one.